Hello, Benjamin from Eclipse here. So at Eclipse IoT, we do interesting things around protocols, right? We believe that it's important to have open source implementations of standards like MQTT or CoAP in order to facilitate and to make it possible to implement your IoT communication scenarios. Now, there are interesting initiatives like AllScene or Open Interconnect Consortium that go a bit further than that, and that wants to standardize the workflows for doing discovery, for doing provisioning for devices. So today I want to focus on Open Internet Consortium and the open source implementation of the OIC standard, which is IoTivity, in order to show you how you can integrate IoTivity and OIC with Eclipse IoT technology. So today it's going to be integration with Eclipse SmartHome. Eclipse SmartHome is a framework for building home automation solutions. And basically, you can develop new plugins to make Eclipse SmartHome aware of your specific technology. So I developed a binding for IoTivity, which makes it possible to discover IoTivity compatible devices in the context of Eclipse SmartHome. So what I'm going to do is actually show you how it works. So let's just look at the demo. All right, so Eclipse SmartHome is a framework for building home automation solutions, right? And what I have here is the Open Hub sample environment, test environment. Open Hub is the packaging of Eclipse SmartHome in the form of something that's really easy to use, comes with a nice web UI and things like that. So in this demonstration environment, there are several plugins, several so-called Eclipse SmartHome bindings available. And I added mine, the implementation of the IoTivity binding, right? So that would be my Open Hub / Eclipse SmartHome workspace. Now I'm basically gonna launch SmartHome, right? It's gonna bootstrap the complete environment, load all my bindings, start the web UI, all right? And then once this is started, I basically just need to go to my web browser and open the actual web UI. Now, Open Hub provides several interfaces. I'm gonna use the very shiny paper UI. And what I have here is basically a nice UI listing a bunch of existing things that are part of the demonstration environment. Okay, they are organized in nice sections. So what I want to do now is try and discover IoTivity devices. So it looks like there is a setup wizard, right? And this setup wizard actually provides me with a list of services that were discovered, depending on my IP address, a weather service is available that I could actually go and provision in my environment. I want to list the weather as part of the weather section of my UI. All right, can go back to the control section, have a look at the weather, and interestingly enough, there is the weather information that in a few minutes is probably going to be refreshed, right? Can actually force that. Well, it's going to show up in a bit. Now, how do I discover in my network IoTivity devices? Well, it doesn't look like there is any at the moment, but IoTivity provides a way to use IP multicast to discover on your local network any IoTivity compatible device that would be listed there. So what I'm going to do is launch an IoTivity example that is available from the IoTivity source code repository. I'm going to launch this new IoTivity server. It's actually going to represent a light. So let's go and start the server, and boom, in the Open Hub UI, in the Eclipse SmartHome UI, the device is now listed with actually all the metadata that allows me to actually identify it. It's Jump Light, and I can go ahead and finish the provisioning And maybe before actually doing that, I want to go and configure a new group in the UI so as the IoTivity devices are listed in a dedicated section of the UI. Let's go and create IoTivity section, go back to the setup wizard, finalize the IoTivity thing provisioning. I want it to be part of the IoTivity group. And now I can go back to my control UI, look for the IoTivity tab, and boom, the light is there. Now it's showing zero powers because basically the sample that I launched is just exposing the resource, but I can use another part of the examples that come with IoTivity to actually come and simulate an actual light power that is going to change over time. So let's go and launch the light client, and boom, I do have my my light evolving in the web UI. There is another part to the demo that is to actually use another IoTivity device. Well, now this one is actually not really compatible with multicast. It's not really discoverable, but still it's an IoTivity device. So we can actually go ahead and configure the device manually in the Smart Home UI. In the setup wizard, you can see that even if the thing isn't really discovered, there is a way to manually add the device. So this is what I'm going to do here. I want to add an IoTivity binding. It's not being discovered, so I'm going to add it manually. So the binding allows me to declare, for example, a light, which is what I'm doing here, declaring the light. And again, it's going to be shown in the IoTivity section. This device is actually this guy, the Kinoma Create board. So I developed a little IoTivity compatible stack on there. Let's just declare this. And the configuration parameter for the thing is actually the URI to the co-op resource for the light power. Earlier, it was discovered automatically via the multicast thingy. Now, in this case, I want to actually input the full URL of my co-op resource, and that's basically it. So let's go back to the control section and see what's going to be in there. Well, it doesn't look like the Kinoma device is there just yet, but let's just launch the dedicated application. Okay, and now I can actually use a potentiometer to simulate light power, which you can see being reflected directly in the Smart Home UI. So that's actually pretty neat. I hope you find that useful. Feel free to comment on the YouTube video, subscribe to the channel to see more videos and tutorials in the future. Thanks.